This is the first sort of video that I'm doing that isn't a live stream, but I'm doing it in the same sort of format because it's a lot easier to put together because I don't have to edit it. So, I mean, all I'm going to do is just go through, make some sounds as I normally do, and then you'll just be, a bit of a viewer of me making sounds. Now, a lot of the time, obviously, I'm making sounds on my own, so I don't actually say anything, but I'll try and talk. But this way, there'll be no sort of questions or anything like that. It'll just be for you to kind of follow, really. So, let me make sure I get everything all sorted. So, what have I got here? I'm not showing all of the keyboard, but it is what it is, isn't it, really? So that's one of theirs. The last one I did was on C1, which... Okay, so shift, patch. So we're still sticking with the JX3P engine. And as I've said before, the default sound is just, what is it? Seems to be about 100 mix, which is about, what's that, a third? It's not loud enough. Two thirds in, turn it up. Not all the way to the top, otherwise once you start adding the second oscillator and then things like resonance and things like, it'll build up and, you know, you could sort of internally, cause it to clip. So about two thirds. So what shall I do here? I'm not too sure. The sync and things like that are on oscillator 2, so that's all the funky bits. So keep the simplistic and the body type sounds for oscillator 1, and the things that are going to create more tonal changes for oscillator 2. That's if I do. So I'm going to keep it there. I'll do a bit of a pad. So bring that attack up. But, you know, the best thing to do is just turn them all off. So if you can hear rare cars. Or it's the problem living with in Blackpool. Especially when they've just had like an air show and it's just full of people. Anyway, I go off on a tangent, as I do. So, turn it all off, so then all you're hearing is each stage. Now, you don't have to worry too much about if that's too fast or too slow, because we can use the filter to do that. Now, it's a pad, so really, we want it to continue. That's oscillator 1. Oscillator 2. Still a saw. Let's knock that up. Two octaves. Some overtone in there. I don't think it's to do with the sample rex, it's 96 kilohertz on it. But... Strange. So I'm just going to turn that down, bring up oscillator 1 again, then bring up oscillator 2. An overtone, try the different wave shapes, which there aren't much. like the really thin pulse width one. Let's add a bit of detune to that. Trying out a couple of things, ideas. I've got a couple of questions in my head of thinking, okay, bloody seagulls. One, having some kind of LFO just on oscillator two going in and out of tune, or a really fast one, but leave oscillator one. So I'm just going to mimic that as much as I can. A bit crappy, but using the, not the fine tune, the coarse tune. So what I've done there, though, is gone down to create a seventh. Which I kind of like that, actually. So there's, let's check out the detune on it. Yeah, I think the fine tune, it'll work well. So what we've done there, we've gone down. It doesn't tell you in cents on here. It's just from, it's minus 52. But I think if we use a slow LFO on the pitch of oscillator 2, just a bit of a fine amount of it. Give that a go. So it's you're going to create your own kind of chorus, really. Now, it sounds a little more out of tune because volume-wise, they're pretty similar. Bearing in mind that we're 2 octaves higher on oscillator 2, so that can give the impression of standing out more, being louder. So we could actually knock down oscillator 2. And because we're blending it in more with oscillator 1, out of tuneness will become less obvious. So we get that kind of chorus, but it also sounds a little like a slow pulse width, but of course we can't modulate that. Once we start adding chorus to that, that'll kind of help glue that together a bit more. So let me just write that for now. Make sure this is recording because I haven't done it this way before. Looks like it is. The sirens are out in full. The drunks are out. Blackpool. But you just love it. Well, it seems to be recording, so... Okay, then. So, we've got that. So, I've not done anything with the filter yet. Now, why don't we... I'm thinking, just to say it out loud, I'm thinking about using that metal side of things. But again, that's going to limit me to a shape of there. Why don't I? No, I'm going to mess with the filter first of all. I'm going to get my filter shape. Then I'll give it a bash. Give it a go. So I'm going to go for a slow fading. So cut off, completely off. Envelope amount is in the middle, and there should be absolutely nothing there, really. There isn't. Envelope amount up full. Might just hear something. I've got the key follow up full. Now, if I just bring up attack. So bringing up that attack quite a way, it's just like someone grabbing the filter cut off and just going slowly sweeping it up. That's going the full amount from dark to bright. Now, what we can do is just bring down the envelope amount. See the shape here, there's a little bit of a dip on the decay, so it's going to go up, dip down a little bit, and then it's going to go back up because the sustain is higher than the decay. Exaggerate that more with the envelope amount. Seems to be cutting out that decay stage. And that's a JX3P thing. So it's brighter at the top, darker at the bottom. That's fine. I'm just going to try this sync. I've got it set. That's going to change it because it's LFO. No, give it a try. It didn't. All it's going to do, the metal, is just change the pitch as well. So it's like adding this as a pitch envelope to oscillator one, which you don't really want to do. Going to fill that down a bit more. Now, with it going darker, it's going to start to sound a little bit more brassier, so we'll have to bring up that release a bit more. Sensitivity. Now this will make it darker, quieter you play. It'll also make it brighter the harder you hit it. Write that. Now what I'm after now, ideally I'd love to have a second LFO to create some kind of do-do-do-do-do-do over the top quivering. But you can't do that because we've already got it tied up. But what we could do is there's another way of doing a similar thing with other synths. Things like ring modulator can do that quite well. It can act like another LFO, but on here we're going to use the chorus effect. Excuse me. But not the JX3P chorus. We're going to use the one that's on the delay chorus thing. So got chorus one and chorus two. I find chorus two a little bit too wide. So chorus one, we're going to turn it up a touch. Mean, it's kind of getting there already before we even done anything. So let's stick on key hold. So leave the key hold going and then just have a play with it. Time for the speed and level will be the amount that we get, but it does affect everything else as well. So, crackers. That sounds nice, but it's not what I'm after. It's that, so now we'll drop the level. Sustain, we'll probably hear it more, or it might blend more the brighter it is actually. It's okay, I'm gonna bring up that level a touch because the oscillators aren't that high. Got the JX3P. Never seen the point of the brightness, to be honest with you. They should have left that as tone as it was, because you could add more bass to the left and make it thinner. Oh, excuse me. To the right. So, but we can get a similar thing if we go to, you got overdrive and distortion. Set the distortion just very low and the tone quite low down, and just bring it in, you can hear more low end coming. So it's off at the moment, but we're going to bring it in. Here. Just a little bit, but that's without any, it's not distorting. Yeah. So we just add that little bit of warmth back in. Because we've got a resonant sound on here. That's fine. We can go to condition. Just add a little bit of that. Whatever, I don't know, about 56, something like that. I'm not scientific about it. Now we've tied up the chorus, tied up that, so that we've only really got a bit of reverb we can use. So, as I said, it's up to you, but I tend to use the modulated one, turn it up a fair bit, and then just control it by level. Time. I mean, ideally it would be delays on that, but we've used. That's cool. I like that. Let's check out, because it's a slow LFO, if we turn down the pitch of the mod wheel and then turn the filter all the way up, we should get a sweep. So we can add some sort of changes to it. So I'm going to write that blah 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 blah. And there's our pad.